applications of solar thermal energy in water purification or water desalination. Let us see how we can use solar energy to purify water. The equipment used to purify water or desalinate water. So here water being named is impure or saline water. It is quite useful where water is, in which water the salinity of water is pretty much higher. Okay. So there is a green energy product. It uses only solar energy. So a solar still works on two basic principles. Very simple principle, as all of you are aware, evaporation and condensation. Evaporation is the change of phase of a substance from liquid to vapor, and condensation is just opposite. So in general, solar stills or solar distillation systems could be classified into two: passive and active solar stills. Passive system are in which solar energy collected by structure elements, that is basin liner. You have studied in liquid flat plate collectors. Some liners having very high absorptivity are placed on the basin or on the absorber plate. So in passive systems, the energy will be collected by the basin liners and it will help in evaporation of water. But in active systems, in active solar stills, an additional thermal energy by solar flat plate collectors with circulating pump, additional condenser, etc. would be provided to help in easing evaporation. This is a simple cross-sectional schematic diagram of a single slope solar still. As you can see here, there is a basin with very thick insulation on the bottom as well as on the sides. And inside the basin, you can see water for a certain thickness. And there is a glass cover on the top, which is usually placed in an angle, tilted angle. So when solar radiation touches the glass will transmit the thermal radiation into the basin. The long wave radiation, short wave radiation will convert it into long wave, and the glass will not allow the long wave radiation to go out. Right? Greenhouse effect. Now, as a result of heating the basin of the solar still, the water gets evaporated and the water vapor, the steam, is actually not the steam, evaporation is taking place, not boiling. So, water droplets will start its journey from the water surface, free water surface, towards the glass. Inside the glass, the water particles, water vapor particles will be collected or will be in contact with the inner surface of the glass cover. Whenever a water vapor or any vapor touches a solid substance, what will happen? The Reynolds process will begin immediately. That is condensation. Since the glass cover is placed at an angle, the condensed water droplets will start traveling in this direction and will be collected in the water collection tower, which can be taken out using a tap or an open. So these are the working principles. Whatever I have explained so far are given in the coming two slides, this one and the second one. So you can go through that. Please listen to the lecture and at the same time read these points, so you understand the entire working of a solar still. It will be quite useful. Each and every sentence I have given clearly, so you can easily note it down. That will be quite useful for your examinations. Only this much is sufficient in solar still. So these are the different types of solar still. Single slope, what we have seen. Then there is a double slope, pyramid type, hemispherical, and conical type. So this is a single slope solar still. When you add one more like this without this partition, here you can see this is a single slope. When you add the other one on the opposite side, we will get a double slope solar still. Obviously, there is no partition. Okay. This is a pyramid type solar still. You can see a house is construction. So more area of contact with the solar energy. So more energy will be transmitted into the basin. At the same time, the thickness of the water in the basin should be determined properly. If the water level in this basin is quite high, what will happen? It will take a longer time to evaporate the water. So we should be very careful to maintain optimum water level. This is a hemispherical type. So only difference in the types are the construction in the glass and the basin. The working principle remains the same. This is a conical type solar still, which is most commonly used in ships to desalinate sea water to drinkable water by adding some minerals. I hope it is clear and understood. If you have any doubts, please revert. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.